Once the flight was airborne, Schaffner went to inform the cockpit crew, while another flight attendant by the name of Tina Mucklow remained by Cooper's side. By using a telephone in the rear of the cabin, Mucklow acted as an intermediary between Cooper and the rest of the flight crew for the remainder of the hijacking. For the next hour and a half, Flight 305 maintained a holding pattern near Seattle, while local and federal authorities scrambled to procure the ransom as well as the four parachutes.